everyone. My name is Claire Sao, and I lead corporate sustainability at Samsung Electronics Semiconductors business. Sustainability is now a very important part of business management, and I'm sure every key player in this industry is making tremendous efforts to set major goals in this area. Samsung Semiconductor, of course, makes sustainability a priority in every facet of our business. Moreover, as a global corporate citizen, we strive to make a positive impact on the field of product and service delivery. As such, we clearly recognize all our stakeholders' sustainability expectations. And we set our goals in the following four key areas: environment, labor and human rights, corporate citizenship, and sustainable supply chain. And I'm very excited to share some of these goals with you today. Of these areas, I'd like to talk about environment. Specifically, on our environmental and sustainability management goals. Our actions to fight climate change through sustainable production and top-notch low-power technology. And our key initiatives that will drive us to more sustainable ecosystems. Let's start with our environmental goals. As you're certainly aware, semiconductors are the foundation of all the technologies we enjoy today. From AI to metaverse, and from IoT to autonomous driving. However, producing semiconductors involves vast amounts of power and water while emitting large amounts of process gas and waste. As a global company, Samsung remains very mindful of this and embraces the responsibility. And so, we built a bold vision for it. Technology that makes technology sustainable. With this slogan, we aim to minimize our impact on nature by carefully managing the entire process of manufacturing, from raw material selection to product development to disposal, with technology at its core. That is why we have made a commitment to significantly minimize our impact on the planet by 2050. By reaching net zero carbon emissions, keeping our water withdrawal stable, recycling waste, and reducing pollutants. Here's how. To reach net zero by 2050, Samsung Semiconductor is developing a new catalyst that increases the efficiency of process gas treatment. And we are expanding the use of renewable energy globally to reduce carbon emissions. As our business constantly grows and more semiconductors are being produced to cover a wide range of industries, more water consumption is only natural. But with our water reusing technology by 2030, we plan to keep the water withdrawal at the level of 2021. While this process of developing and maintaining this technology will be extremely difficult, we are determined to achieve this goal. Next, how we recycle our waste. Though we already have a 96.8% recycling rate globally, which is certainly an achievement by itself, we plan to go further and recycle 99.9% of manufacturing waste by 2030. Lastly, we plan on reducing air and water pollutants discharged from the manufacturing process, keeping the level at a natural state. As you can see, our pollutant discharge level is already lower than the legal standard and below the industry average. However, we plan to go a step further by achieving a natural state by 2040. This is going to be a challenging task for us. And to do this, we will put our best efforts into developing new and innovative technologies that minimize pollutants discharged. At the same time, we will pursue new manufacturing processes that will not produce any pollutants. Having shared some of our goals with you today, here are some key achievements we have already reached in our journey towards these goals. Understanding that climate change is one of the most pressing issues. Samsung Semiconductor focused on reducing process gas and energy usage. We developed our own facility called RCS to treat process gas. RCS has more than 95% processing efficiency. We have also achieved the use of 100% renewable energy at operation sites abroad, including places like the US, China, and the EU. And we are expanding the practice further in Korea. Now onto water management efforts. In 2021, we reused 175,000 tons of water on a daily basis. And we treat all water before discharging it with advanced purification systems. Going one step further, we achieved a 96.8% recycling rate for waste, and we obtained zero waste to landfill certifications for every global site. In 2022, we obtained the platinum level for all domestic sites. By 2025, we will obtain platinum for all global sites. In 2021, our efforts were recognized with a triple standard label from the Carbon Trust, a certification only given to the companies that go beyond given standard in reducing carbon emissions, water usage, and waste. I'll now move on to our efforts in producing eco-conscious products to convey accurate information to our customers on a product-product basis. Samsung Semiconductor tries to be as precise on our carbon footprint measurement as we can and do our best in lowering them. Let's explore some of these efforts.
What can we do to help clear the skies and keep the air fresh?
At Samsung Semiconductor, we develop advanced technology to make low-power chips. And we strive to reduce our carbon footprint throughout the production process. Our relentless efforts have gained global recognition by the UK's Carbon Trust. We were the first in the semiconductor industry to earn the CO2 measured label. This was made possible by measuring carbon emissions and calculating the vast amount of data throughout a product's life cycle. From extracting the raw material, transporting the material, and manufacturing the chips, to using the chips in our daily lives, and disposing of them. And since 2019, our products have continued to receive CO2 measured labels by the Carbon Trust. But we didn't stop there. We kept reducing and improving, making our carbon footprint even smaller. We improved our production rate accuracy because fewer defects mean higher quality, but also less waste. As a result, we became the first in the semiconductor industry to be awarded the reducing CO2 label.
Thanks to our team's continuing efforts, in 2020, we achieved our first carbon-reduced product certification. And again, in 2021, our core memory products also gained this certification. From this, we reduced 680,000 tons of greenhouse gas emissions while manufacturing these certified products. We are dedicated to continuing this drive and to seeking every possible option to reduce the carbon emissions. In addition to carefully measuring the carbon footprint of our key products, we are also in the process of establishing our own life cycle assessment. The LCA requires not only the carbon emissions from manufacturing sites, but also a lot of data from raw materials production to waste disposal. Despite the many complications of manufacturing semiconductors, we at Samsung are applying the best methodology to build an accurate LCA database tailored to each product line. And in the near future, we plan to have third parties assess our LCA database in order to establish its validity and raise its credibility. We are also driven to lower emissions in LCA. We are reducing the carbon emissions in our sites. And at the same time, we are looking for ways to replace raw materials with low emissions in the producing stage from the development level. Of course, it is not just our production sites working to reduce carbon emissions. Our products do too. Let's take a look at some of the most innovative technologies we have been developing to reduce energy consumption and where we are heading with them. From a technical perspective, our plan for maximizing energy saving for data center, AI, and high computing PC is next level process and design technology. The first to ever implement EUV process, and utilizing dynamic voltage technology, LPDDR5X improved its speed by 30% and power efficiency by 20% from its predecessor. Moreover, thanks to high-k metal gate and TSV technology, DDR5 also saw a 125% improvement in speed and a 30% improvement in power efficiency from its predecessor. Quite amazing. We have also kept pushing to improve flash memory's performance and power efficiency. Take SSD for example. By separately implementing and applying the most optimal design and the latest technology to each of its components, namely the controller, DRAM, NAND, our SSD's reading and writing speed improved by 80%. And power efficiency by 30% from its former version. These results show that our confidence that through innovative technology, Samsung Semiconductor can truly contribute to achieving net zero in our global tech industry and beyond. Next up are some key initiatives that we will actively participate in for our environment. Samsung Semiconductor works with various stakeholders to ensure our products are being designed, manufactured, supplied, and used in an environmentally conscious manner. Earlier at SEMI Sustainability Summit, we shared some of our achievements on reducing greenhouse gas. There, we also shared a common goal and need to urgently tackle environmental issues across industry's value chain. We will continue to be an active participant and contributor to solving this issue. Moreover, we want to go further. We have recently joined OCP Sustainability Initiatives. Through this, we work with our customers in data center industry to extend our positive impact on our product's user level. Here, our main focus is to seek ways in which used semiconductors can be redesigned and reused, and in the end, contribute to the circularity demand. To effectively and clearly communicate with our stakeholders, we need to set a universal index and standard. With the impact of semiconductors in global business growing, the industry has also been receiving a lot of attention and more demand. However, many of these demands do not fully consider the characteristics of this industry. That is why we intend to propose a new index, one that presents a clear guideline and standard in this industry, and in the end, acts as a basis for clearer communication with our stakeholders. This new index is called the Semiconductor Environmental Performance Index, or SEPI. We will actively use SEPI to communicate with the public and stakeholders alike on Samsung Semiconductor's eco-conscious efforts. Our aspiration is that this goes beyond internal use to help reach unified goals for sustainability. In the future, we will use SEPI alongside other indices like TCFD and taxonomy to better and more transparently communicate with our stakeholders. As a key partner in the global tech supply chain, Samsung Semiconductor will continue to strive to develop innovative core technologies and responsibly address the challenges facing our environment. We will continue our journey. Technology that makes technology sustainable. Thank you.